Hey everyone, how's it going? Today I'm playing in my tier 10 German medium tank, the Leopard 1. And I was asked to post a game where I carried the match in my Leopard 1. And hopefully this is going to be good enough, because it's the closest thing I've gotten in 9.3. I actually had a few games from 9.2 where I would say I carried pretty well in them. I saved the replay file and the end cards and everything, and I forgot to record them before 9.3 rather came out. So unfortunately, the replays can no longer be viewed. I haven't been able to get my hands on a installation of 9.2, so unfortunately those replays are just gone for good as far as I'm concerned. And my original plan was to get on the one line high up on the hill close to the map boundary and shoot the enemy surfers that tried to spot their midridge, because that's a good position to actually counter what this Object 140 is doing. But I saw that the Walker Bulldog on our team was going to basically sit in spawn and try and passive scout there for whatever reason. So I decided that I would be the one surfing, even though it's not exactly what the Leopard is good at. And as soon as I do that, the Walker Bulldog moves up to kind of surf a little bit. So you're basically damned if you do, damned if you don't sometimes. And it looks like the M1R3 on our team is possibly in a position to shoot the Object 140. But he probably won't have the accuracy to do so. And here, I saw I got spotted. Not by the Object 140 originally, but by something else. And you can kind of use Sixth Sense to more or less determine where an enemy is. Since I wasn't spotted by the Object 140, the only other place I could be spotted from, basically, was that bush where I'm blind firing. And I'm guessing that the Walker Bulldog on the enemy team is sitting in one of those bushes and spotting me every time I fire or go close enough. Spoiler though, none of my shots end up hitting him. But I do hit that guy. And now I'm just kind of set up to shoot the enemy tanks that are pushing up onto the hill, giving my team as much support as possible, since they're being kind enough to actually light these tanks for me. Our tanks that we invested on the one line are being spotted by the enemy Walker Bulldog, and taking quite a bit of damage. Our Bulldog is not being very useful, unfortunately, and is about to run into the enemy Walker Bulldog very shortly and die, because he tried to fight a fully upgraded Bulldog with a stock Bulldog, and that just does not work out. But I'm giving up trying to blind fire that guy. It's just more or less a waste of my time. I'd rather support the team on the hill, as I feel that that is a more crucial area on this map than the one line. And as long as my team on the one line don't push up into tank destroyers like they're doing, they should be fine. Yep. Our Bulldog gets killed by their Bulldog for no damage done, and then blames us for not supporting him when he was in an area that none of us could actually shoot, and he should have just run away, but he didn't. So now we're down one tank. Although, to be honest, it's not that much of a loss. But we did lose an E-75, which is a very important tank, unfortunately. But I'm in a good position here to just rail on these enemy tanks as they try to push up this hill. M41 Walker Bulldog gets taken out. I guess he got spotted by either our Centurion or our Wolfentrager Alpha Panzer IV, who for whatever reason went out into the open and then got shot by artillery. And I'll just fast forward through this little bit of no action, because basically nothing happens for almost a full minute. Enemy Centurion 7/1 pushes over the hill and dies very quickly. And the enemy T-57 Heavy is also about to die. That's a very important tank that the enemy team just lost. So that's excellent for us. We just lost our mouse. I mean, not exactly the most important tank for us on this map, but definitely would have been nice to have him alive. Mouse is basically just a bullet sponge after all. It looks like our team is actually, I should say, our team on the hill is actually going to be aggressive here soon. And they're going to push over and down the enemy side of the hill very shortly. Which is always nice to see when a team is actually aggressive and does what they need to do. Seems like people play really passively in this game a lot of the times. I mean, in my Leopard, I definitely have to play passively if I want to make use of my health. So that means playing from the back, not getting spotted as much as possible. Because your armor is basically your health pool in this tank. And the more health you have, the more dangerous you become in the later stages of the game. So you really have to play for the end game in this tank, if you can. Like, obviously there's times where you'll have to be brave for your team and lead the charge, basically. And that really sucks, but someone has to do it, and sometimes that happens to be the least armored tank on your team. Not fully aimed, but I kind of expected with 0.3 accuracy that that would at least hit the enemy object 140, but such is life, I suppose. And here I'm just trying to pick up their Wolfentrager Alpha Panzer IV, or any of their tank destroyers, really. They're just sitting in the back. Spotted that T-30, who is about to die. Bit of an overkill shot from our our Jagdpanzer E-100 there. 1,000 damage shell, and does 66 damage. Now I'm about to do a bit of a misplay here. I want to go hunting this Object 140. Fire alert, this attack. It's a very crucial tank for the enemy team to have, especially with this much health, so I either want to kill him or get him to back off. And this is not the smartest thing I've ever done, getting into a DPM fight with a Russian medium. The Leopard 1's DPM is not actually that bad, but it's not good enough to outfight a 140 most of the time. Luckily though, the last shot he does only tracks me. And our artillery finishes them off. So now the middle's clear. It's just an enemy Jagdpanzer on this side of the tracks. Jagdpanzer E-100, I should say. And our 112 is asking for help, so it looks like he's going to be pushing down the hill and going to try and harass the Jagdpanzer E-100, so I want to be in a position to support him. Trying to stay behind the bush so I stay camo while firing. But it looks like, as I was aiming for his lower plate at the last second, he turned his tank to aim at the 112, so my shot just buries itself into his freight track. Still in a good position to support this 112, however, because he's going to be coming around and underneath and ultimately behind the Jagdpanzer E-100. So he's going to have to turn his tank to shoot at the 112, which will give me shots into his side. The Jagdpanzer E-100 actually spots me there, and I did not know this at the time, but you can actually get shot from the one line sitting where I was. And I believe that was the enemy Waffenträger Aufpanzer 4 that hit me. Unless the enemy T-95 is using a 20mm. Not 20mm, 120mm. Could you imagine if the T-95 had a 20mm cannon? I get spotted again somehow. I guess the enemy Waffenträger spotted me. Because he does have pretty good view range, I should say. His view range is as good as mine. Base view range, anyways. I actually use coated optics on my Leopard, so I have about 483 meters view range. And of course, I can't spot outside of that 445 meter spotting range hard cap, but the higher my view range, the easier it'll be for me to spot tanks inside of that circle. And we actually don't have that much time left to kill these remaining enemy tanks. But the artillery is dead, so that's good. I'm trying to get my team to realize that it is definitely time to start moving up along the one line and putting pressure on the enemies. Conqueror gun carrier takes out their T-95. I've loaded high explosive anti-tank for this E-4. It's not something I do very often, but when I need to guarantee that I penetrate every shot, I will load the occasional heat round. Despite doing 5,700 damage, I actually didn't get that much experience that round, mostly because I was not doing self-spotting. My team were actually lighting most of the targets I shot for me, so some of my experience went to them for doing the spotting. But I did come away with 5,730 damage and 1,050 experience, which is quite a bit higher than basically anybody else on my team. And as you can see, most of that damage was actually done from a distance of 300 or more meters. So yeah, definitely using the Leopard in its intended role as a long-range sniper tank. So anyways guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and maybe I'll catch you next time. Happy hunting!